Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 4th of August. Heavy rain batters India's financial capital, Mumbai, disrupting traffic. Indian envoy to UN outlines Pakistan's direct involvement in manufacturing terror. And Sri Lankan president issues proclamation, new parliament to meet on August 20th. And now for all the details. Authorities in India's financial capital of Mumbai issued a red alert on Tuesday and warned people not to venture out after heavy overnight rain brought flooding and travel chaos. Some suburbs have seen more than 300 mm of rain in the 24 hours to Tuesday morning, and more heavy rain is expected over the next 2 days, said India's weather office. Heavy showers in India's financial capital of Mumbai and neighbouring areas have crippled normal life and disrupted rail and road traffic on Tuesday amid coronavirus pandemic. Authorities issued a red alert for the city for the next 2 days. The governing civil body, Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation, appealed to residents to stay at home and urged commercial establishments except those providing essential services to remain closed on Tuesday. Several areas in the city and suburbs received more than 200 mm rainfall since Monday night, and heavy showers were likely to continue for next 48 hours, according to the India Meteorological Department.
In 10 hours, 230 mm rain fell. 230 mm rainfall हुआ है, बहुत high rainfall है, flood like situation है. इसके कारण जो मिठी river है, उसका water level जो danger level है, वो 27 meter है, 34 meter पे चला गया था. हमने सुबह evacuation शुरू कर दिया था लोगों का कुरला slum में, परंतु अभी वो level 34 से 24 पे आ गया है, मतलब कि danger level से 3 meter खाली आ गया है. अभी हमने फिलहाल उसको रोक दिया एवैक्यूएशन, क्योंकि पानी अभी वहाँ जाना बंद हो गया है.
मैं पिछले डेढ़ से दो घंटे से यहाँ पे खड़ा हूँ, फुल बारिश है यहाँ पे, पानी कम हो ही नहीं रहा. दूसरा रूट जाने के लिए मटुंगा सर्कल आएगा, हाँ. लेकिन वहाँ पे भी आगे जो परल पे इससे ज़्यादा पानी है, हाँ. तो अभी तक मैं यहाँ पे खड़ा हूँ, जब पानी कम होगा तो यहाँ से मैं देखेंगे जाऊँगा रिटर्न.
Mumbai struggles with the monsoon rains every year as widespread construction and rubbish clogged drains and waterways make it increasingly vulnerable to flooding. The city is also struggling with the surging coronavirus outbreak, with an average of 1,000 new cases being reported every day. Ahead of the first anniversary of the revocation of special status to India's northern Jammu and Kashmir on 5th of August, the administration has imposed curfew in main city Srinagar from Monday until Wednesday. The move has been taken due to intelligence about the potential violent protests. Indian soldiers patrolled streets and kept watch from the rooftops in Jammu and Kashmir's main city of Srinagar on Tuesday, on the eve of the first anniversary of the revocation of Article 370 that gave the special status to the erstwhile state. Authorities imposed a curfew in Srinagar late on Monday until Wednesday in view of inputs that Pakistan-sponsored groups are planning to observe protests on August 5, and also specific inputs about violent protests endangering public life and property. Roads and streets were deserted and shops remained closed as armed security personnel guarded the summer capital Srinagar to prevent any untoward incidents.
दो दिन कर्फ्यू कंटिन्यू चलेगा, क्योंकि कल जो 5 अगस्त है इसीलिए कर्फ्यू लगाया गया है. तो मैं बहुत दूर से आया, कहीं कहीं छोड़ा भी नहीं मुझे, आज पूरा मुझे दिख रहा है कि नहीं जी कर्फ्यू कहीं कहीं लग रहा है.
On August 5, 2019, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government revoked Article 370 that gave special status to erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir and bifurcated the region into two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, which officially came into existence from October 31st. Modi's government has said the move was necessary to spur economic development and to better integrate the region with the rest of the country. However, people also held protests against the decision. Moving on, India's permanent representative to the United Nations, Ambassador T.S. Tirumurthy, has lashed out at Pakistan for harboring terror groups and called it a nerve center of terrorism. In an exclusive interview to ANI News Agency, the ambassador said Pakistan is home to the largest number of listed terrorists internationally and designated terrorist entities, and that there is a clear acknowledgement of this.
India's permanent representative to the United Nations, T.S. Tirumurthy, while speaking to ANI News Agency on Tuesday, said that UN has over the time in its reports reiterated Pakistan's involvement in terrorist attacks abroad. Tirumurthy said it's a well-known fact that Pakistan is the nerve center of terrorism. Pakistan is home to the largest number of listed terrorists, internationally designated terrorist entities and individuals, including Jamaat-ud-Dawa, Lashkar-e-Taiba, JEM and Hizbul Mujahideen. Referring to United Nations 26th report of the Analytical Support and Sanctions Monitoring Team concerning ISIS, the ambassador asserted there is a clear acknowledgement that the leadership and funding for the terrorist entities like Al-Qaeda and ISIS emanate from Pakistan.
1267 committee, which submits its report periodically on terrorist activities of ISIL, Al-Qaeda and its affiliates. It has several direct references to Pakistan's involvement.
The Indian diplomat on Pakistan's attempts to internationalize the Jammu and Kashmir matter last year said that attempts have fallen flat and have not borne any fruit to Islamabad. Pakistan, which has fought three wars with India over Kashmir, responded to the decision by downgrading diplomatic ties and suspending bilateral trade. India also accuses it of spreading unrest in the Kashmir Valley.
In news from Pakistan, as Pakistan has resumed polio vaccination across the country after the coronavirus pandemic forced months-long halt, vaccinators are complaining of unprecedented challenges they face while providing door-to-door service now. The health workers, who also have to take precautionary measures to curb the virus spread, said people frustrated over the COVID health crisis often get angry on them when they try to educate them about polio vaccine and its importance.
As Pakistan has resumed polio vaccination across the country after the coronavirus pandemic forced months-long halt, vaccinators are complaining of unprecedented challenges they face while providing door-to-door service now. The health workers in Karachi city said people are frustrated over the COVID-19 health crisis and often get angry on them when they try to educate them about polio vaccine and its importance.
अमूमन सुपरवाइज़र घर वालों के रवैयों की शिकायत लेकर आ रहे हैं और खसूसन कोरोना वायरस की वजह से जो बेरोज़गारी बढ़ी है तो लोग बहुत ज़्यादा फ्रस्ट्रेशन का शिकार हो गए हैं जिसकी वजह से वो फ्रस्ट्रेशन जाहिर सी बात है जो गेट पे आते हैं उसी पे निकाल ले होते हैं
The vaccinators have to now wear face masks, gloves and take other precautionary measures, which is also a challenge itself.
मुश्किलात बस ये हैं कि चूँकि कोविड के हवाले से लोग भी परेशान हैं डिस्टर्ब हैं हम लोग भी जो कि एहतियातन उनसे फासला मेंटेन करें ये करें वो करें यानी इन सब चीज़ों पर फोकस करना और उनका फोकस लेकर आना ये सब मुश्किलात हो रही हैं
अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑफिशियल फिगर्स 60 पोलियो केसेस हैव बीन रिपोर्टेड दिस ईयर इन पाकिस्तान केसेस फेल टू 8 इन 2017 एंड 12 इन 2018 but then spiked up to 147 in 2019, according to World Health Organization. Disruption of the anti-polio drive due to COVID-19 has raised fears of a spike in the polio cases in Pakistan, which along with neighboring Afghanistan, is just one of the two countries in the world where the disease remains endemic.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. The Islamic State group attacked a prison in eastern Afghanistan, leading to an hours-long battle on Monday. Afghan security forces killed at least 10 Islamic State fighters who had taken control of a prison, ending a siege in which hundreds of prisoners escaped.
Afghan security forces on Monday killed at least 10 Islamic State fighters who had taken control of a prison in the eastern city of Jalalabad, ending a siege in which hundreds of prisoners escaped. At least 29 people were killed and 50 were wounded in the militants' assault on the prison on Sunday evening and subsequent clashes with security forces, officials said. According to the Defense Ministry, two security force members were also killed in the attack. According to the spokesman for the governor of Nangarhar province, Ataullah Khugyani, more than 300 prisoners were still at large. Of the 1,793 prisoners, more than 1,025 had tried to escape and been recaptured, and 430 remained inside. The violence comes at a sensitive time for Afghanistan as the United States attempts to usher peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban, who they say oppose Islamic State and have fought against them. Islamic State claimed responsibility for the attack, which came a day after the Afghan intelligence agency said special forces had killed a senior Islamic State commander near Jalalabad, the provincial capital.
As Sri Lankans prepare to head to the polls on Wednesday to elect 225 members of parliament, Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has summoned the new parliament to meet on 20th of August following the general election. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has summoned a new parliament to meet on 20th of August following the general election scheduled to be held on Wednesday. President's media division in a statement announced that the extraordinary gazette notification announcing the summoning of the new parliament was issued Monday night. President Rajapaksa had earlier dissolved the 8th parliament on 2nd March. Sri Lankans now prepare to head to the polls on August 5th to elect 225 members of parliament. The vote has been delayed twice in April and June due to the coronavirus, and campaign restrictions remain in place, such as limits on numbers at rallies and door-to-door campaigning. The Sri Lanka Podojana Peramuna, or SLPP, led by the current Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, is tipped to win. He was appointed to the post by his younger brother Gotabaya Rajapaksa, who won the presidency last November. The SLPP's main opponent is the Samaji Jana Balavegaya, led by the opposition leader Sajid Premadasa, son of a former president and Prime Minister of Sri Lanka. The country was in lockdown to curb the spread of the virus from March until April 20, when restrictions began to gradually ease.
At least 8 workers, including an Indian national at the construction site and 2 members of a family, lost their lives due to landslides triggered by heavy rain in Nepal on Monday. According to an official in the affected Milamchi municipality, a small town about 30 miles to the north of Nepali capital Kathmandu, all the deceased were workers involved in the construction of a community hall. The officials said the workers had been asleep when the landslide buried their makeshift shelter. A second landslide nearby killed a woman and her husband. Over 150 people lost their lives in various incidents triggered by ongoing monsoon since mid of May in Nepal. The COVID-19 pandemic has changed the way of living, interacting and learning for all. With several schools being shut and classes being held online over coronavirus fear, teachers in India's western village of Dandwal, with no access to internet connectivity and smart devices, have come up with a new way to teach students via loudspeakers. Have a look.
A group of school children in India's western Dandwal village recently attended the first class in months. However, their teacher was not physically in front of them. Instead, the children were taught via loudspeaker. Under an initiative called Bolki Shala, which in the local Marathi language means spoken school, an Indian non-profit has started taking the pre-recorded lessons to students in rural areas who have not been able to go to school 4 months due to the coronavirus lockdowns. Schools in India have been shut for over 4 months. Children in cities have been able to continue classes online, but in places like Dandwal, a poor farming village amid the hills in Maharashtra state, even the phone network and electricity are infrequent and the internet is not an option.
आम्ही सगळा झाली का शाळेची वाट पाहतो ती 8 वाजेला स्पीकर येतो ते स्पीकर खुर्चीवर ठेवतात ते स्पीकर चालू करतात बोलतात त्याच्या मग आम्ही पण बोलतो गाणे सांगतो गोष्टी सांगतो कविता काय काय सांगतो इंग्लिश शब्द सांगतो ते स्पीकर आम्हाला खूप काय शिकवतो स्पीकर दादा स्पीकर ताई कोणी पण आहे तो जाम शिकवतो आम्हाला.
The content in the pre-recorded lessons cover a part of school curriculum as well as school skills and English language lessons. The nascent program covers 6 villages so far and aspires to reach 1,000 students.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.